Hey guys, it's Bunny Head Kid. Today we have a surprise in the mail, and gonna go ahead and open it up and see what's inside. And I do have the hiccups, so pardon me if I hiccup. So today we just had this big box open up my door. Yep. Open up this bar. You'll be able to tell by the cover or the reading on the box of what it is. Alright, so here we go. We've got some foam here. This is the bottom of the box. Take this out. Something we have not seen before. Put this on the ground. And this is my first purchase from Nitro Plains. And if you are able to see the check mark, I have the blue P-51 Mustang. And I got the ready to fly for this because I did. So, let's open up this box. So, once again, this is my first purchase from Nitro Plains and Airfield. So, I'm hoping, to see that they're a good company. Found that there was some tape right here covering up the cover, so that's why I couldn't get it off, but we got it off now, and that's all that matters. So then we have this layer of cardboard that says, "Thank you very much for choosing our products. We will devote our biggest efforts to serve you." And I guess that's just a note from Nitro Plains saying, "Thanks for buying this, buying from our company, blah, blah, blah." Put this tape off. Sorry, this is taking a little long. There's a lot of packaging in here, so. Oh man, I'm liking this plan. Got a lot of stuff taped in here. Because, like I said, I didn't say it, but they don't really have an in-store. They have to ship everything, so everything's all good and safe. This is just a ginormous plane, 1400 milliliter size, so yeah, big plane. And got your manual in here. This is the ready to fly, so it will come with everything except for a charger. So, if you haven't already figured out what the plane is yet, this is the horizontal stabilizer. Might be able to tell by that. Got your control linkages in there that you have to install. Here's the tail. Now you might be able to get in close to what the plane is. Well, actually, you're going to see it because I'm going to post what it is. Right. Here is the fuselage of this massive P-51 Blue Nose. Very big plane. Really scale looking plane. So here's one wing of the plane. And you got the underside on here. It's pretty big wingspan. Here's the other wing. Once again, really scale detail on these wings. And got a lot of stuff in here. Here's your carbon fiber rod for the wings. Really sturdy. And then here is the cowling, the Blue Nose cowling, which I believe. Yes, here's the four-bladed paddle prop we have to put into the cowling. So it's a little bit more assembly needed than Horizon Hobby products, but it's okay. Here's the exhaust little panels you can put on the side. Here's all your hardware and screws, control linkages, all that good stuff in here. In here, let's see, what is in here? A little box here. And inside it, oh, here's the glue. It's really nice how they supply some glue for any gluing you have to do, and I believe the only thing you have to do is just glue the little scale antenna on the back of the plane. But, yeah. And then, over here, you got your big, nice LiCo battery. Let's see, what is the size of this battery? It's, I'm gonna open this up. I believe it's 20-something milliamp. I know it's a, well, let's see. It is a 25C, 14.8 volt. Oh, so it's a 4-cell battery with 2600 milliamps, so. Really big battery. That's good. And the last thing in here is the transmitter. It's a little 2.4 gigahertz. Nothing special or anything, but it's a 2.4 gigahertz airfield, basic controller. Got it. It's not computerized, just got your on switch. Looks like, let's see, got channel 5 switch, which is going to be the retracts. Channel 6 is nothing. So, just your basic 4-channel. But, that's about it that's in the box. This is a really long unboxing. But, again, this is the Blue Nose P-51 from Airfield. Here's the specifications. You can pause it if you want to look at it some more. Pause the video. But so I'm going to go ahead and put this plane together, and then I'll show you guys the finished product. So, wish me good luck.
Here, kid. We're back. This is the ginormous P-51 built. It's just so huge. Like, you can see in comparison to my face, how big this plane is. Like, oh my god, so big. But, you can't really see much from over there, so let's have you guys get closer to this awesome plane. And I started building this around 2:50, and the current time is 5:30, so, not too much of an assembly time. It was a decent amount, though. And
I was having some problems with my motor, but I figured it out because one of the ESC plugs came undone. But, yeah, so this is just a ginormous P-51, and I'm loving this plane. I mean, it's just so scale and so cool looking. So, yeah, here's our little chimpy little controller here. And has a decent amount of elevator here. It's got dual elevator linkages. Tail rudder is pretty good. And the tail wheel also moves under there. And then we got your ailerons here. Nice amount of ailerons. That looks pretty good. And then got your little antenna there. What's pretty cool is these lights. Got red and green pre-installed lights. Got some scale guns on the side. And your huge prop here. And we'll do a little throttle test here. And yeah, that is about like 10% throttle. And oh my god, scared me. Started moving forward a lot. So yeah, 25E motor. Really powerful. And so yeah, got a 4-cell battery. The canopy is a little bit hard to get off. I accidentally pulled the window off because it's attached to the ground. It's really hard to get off without pulling the top window off. But scale pilot, got some scale instruments in there. And here's the inside of the plane. A lot of wires, receiver, got your big 4-cell battery up there. And that's that. I was missing some screws, but I found some other screws in the replacement bag that worked, that came with it, so that was kind of nice. But, my favorite real part about this plane is the retracts. And I'm going to try and show you the retracts pretty good here. Let's see, maybe camera angle there. And then I guess that's not gonna work because I have to pick the plane up. So, wait, let me turn this around so I can see what I'm doing. I guess I need this, but actually, you know what? I have a better way of doing this. I'm gonna put the plane like this. I'll hold it like this. Hold on. Let me just. Kind of hard doing this here with all two hands. So yeah, the main wheels. I'll do gear up. Hold on. I'll try and press it with my knee so I can still get a picture of this. Ugh. Almost got it. Hold on. Turn up. So there you go. Wheels up. And it looks pretty good. But the real cool part is the tail wheel. It has a retractable tail wheel and the doors that go over the tail wheel. So go gear down. Door opens, tail wheels come down. And the tail wheel is steerable once again. And we'll go gear up with these guys one more time. I'll try to. So yeah, some real nice retracts. Let's go gear down. And this plane is really heavy. It's like, I'd say at least weighs like 10 pounds. Real heavy plane. So yeah, I might try and go do some scale taxiing, but you can see there's my pull cap with the top off in comparison to this huge plane. So might even be bigger than my Champ. Need to get that fixed. This thing came undone, and the landing gear pushed in on a rough landing, so. But we'll get him up in the air. And we got this other stuff here, too. And on my Polecat, ailerons are being kind of glitchy. I don't know, they, like, stop working. And, yeah. But that's that, so, bye.